Hello friends, welcome to my channel. Now we shall discuss about the role of the banker. See, banks play a very vital role in economic development of a country, as we already discussed. It influences every aspect of modern economy. Let us see the importance of bank or role of the bank one by one. Banks help the process of capital formation. Banks promote the habit of thrift and savings among the people. Look at it, banks promote the habit of thrift and savings among the people. So it opens or extends its branches over different or every part of the country and try to mobilize the savings of all the people. And for promoting the savings among the people, it gives or it offers a small percentage of rate of interest also on deposits. And so we can attract the people's savings towards bank deposit. Then provide safety and security to the surplus money of the bank deposits or depositors. So a bank itself is a matter of confidence. People are having confidence on bank, and hence they are depositing their money with the bank. The primary duty of the banker is to provide the safety and security to the surplus money of the depositors. It provides convenient and economical means of payment, that is through checks. Here, people want to make comfortable, or people want to be comfortable in making the payment. They want certain media. The bank introduces the checks, which becomes a convenient and economical means of making the payment. Nowadays, banks are also having different digital payment medias or digital payment platforms or payment apps. Is also becoming a useful and convenient media for making payment. Banks provide convenient and economical means of transfer of funds from one place to another place. So with the help of DD, demand draft, or bank draft, or NEFT, or RTGS, or even by using different bank apps, payment apps, the customer can transfer his money from one place to another place, which is a convenient one, or comfortably he can shift his money from one place to another place. It helps the movement of funds from regions where they are not useful to the regions where they are most useful. Some cases, what it happens, you see, in a country, we can classify the areas into developed one and underdeveloped or developed, underdeveloping. Sorry, developed, underdeveloped or developing areas. So here, already developed means there is no urge, there is no debt, or there is no demand for the loans, because already developed. And where there is a developing area or underdeveloped area is there is a debt or there is a demand for loans, then the money collected in one region where it is heavily available and where it is not so useful to lend, then that money can be shifted to the areas where there is most useful. And the banks influence the rate of interest in the money market. So with the supply of money, if the supply of money increases into the money market, the price of the money or the rate of interest will comes down. If the supply of money becomes scarce or less, then demand for money increases, the price for the money also increases, rate of interest increases, it means. So this kind of impact will be done by the bank through the supply of money. Banks help trade, commerce, industry and agriculture by meeting their financial requirements. You see, every trade, commerce industry and agriculture sector requires monetary help. By providing the monetary help, bank will help for the growth of all these sectors in the economy. Then they direct the flow of funds into productive purposes. Always banks are used to lend the money only for the productive purposes. Because if they lend the money for the productive purposes, the regeneration of money is possible, the profit is possible to the borrowers, so that they can repay the money in time without fail. So, for this reason, the flow of they direct the flow of funds into productive purposes. It means they are encouraging the productive purposes, at the same time they are discouraging the non-essential activities. They serve as a financial intermediaries between savers and the investors. So as we already discussed it, in one side we are seeing in the economy two groups. One side we are seeing savers, and the another side we are seeing the investors or borrowers. So here, wow, the savers save their money in the banks. After the collection of deposits, the banks are able to lend the money to the needies, and they lend the money to the needies. These needies or borrowers borrow the money from bank and invest their money on different establishments, business establishments or productive establishments. So that we are seeing these two groups are linked to the bank. Bank become the middleman, or a banker become the intermediary between these savers and the investors. And they manufacture the money. So it doesn't mean that the commercial banks are printing the money. The commercial bank won't print the money because they don't have that right. Only the central bank of a country can have that right. So here, what the commercial bank will do? Commercial bank will create the bank money or credit money. While lending the loans, they are creating a separate loan account. Through that loan account, the amount of loan will be shifted to that loan account. Then there becomes the multiple expansion of deposits. Through the help of multiple expansion of deposit, creation of money is possible, or creation of bank money is possible, creation of checkbook money is possible. Like that, the banker will create the money or manufacture the money. They control the supply of money. You look at it, the bankers are controlling the supply of money. By controlling the supply of money, they are having their influence on economic activities. Means employment, income, and price level in the economy. All the economic activities mainly depend upon the supply of money only. So if the supply of money affected in the economy by the banks, certainly it will affect the economic activities in the country. If suppose the credit become costly, the borrower will not borrow the money. If the banks make the credit costlier, then the borrower's willingness to borrow the money will be postponed. Certainly, how it impacts on the economy? He will not invest. When he will not invest, he will not place the order. So when he will not place the order, demand decreases. When demand decreases, production decreases. When production decreases, it affects upon the employees. Labor cutting or a lockdown of the factory is possible. Then unemployment situation creates. Again, it hinders the income of the employees. When no income is there, no demand is there. When there is no demand, it affects on the price. Price will be reduced. Like this, we are seeing the linked impact on different activities. Maybe on production, employment, income, price. Like this, the supply of money will impact. Last one is they convert the debts of others into money. You look at it, government and joint stock company securities, maybe government bonds or joint stock company shares and debentures are there. They are treated as long-term loans. They convert the long-term loans into debts. They convert this debt into money. Like this, we are having a different role of the banks. So thanks for listening this role of a bank.